performance of that type, it is so complicated. It requires a lot of preparation, obviously, days before, months before, years before, as the performer. But this very day has special timings. I have many teams to coordinate together. I have help, obviously, luckily. I will fly on, hooked on a bunch of balloons, helium balloons, so we first have all to travel to the city where I perform, and apart from my own preparation as a flying actress, physical poetry flying actress, I have my technicians need to inflate the balloons, make sure that there's no balloon that gets damaged. Then there's a whole design of the bunch of balloons, there's a timing to that. The helium will last for just a certain amount of time, so we have to be very straight in the timings, coordinate with the music, and then follow spots, and the light will come off because now it will be nighttime because it's a Christmas. So we don't have the light anymore, which is another challenge. Another very big challenge for me, and for which I will need to protect myself the whole day, is the cold. This type of performance is not made to be performed in the cold. Today is also the first time that the men of my life will see me flying, so that's also very meaningful. It's a lot to take in at the same time, and there's a team that has been trained to do that for years. We have a super good relation to know what's going on also in the moment. It's a 6 minutes performance, but there is years and years of expertise in that little 6 minutes. There is, of course, a factor of danger, of risk, for which I have trained myself physically and psychologically my whole life. I have plan Bs for every little things that could happen, and I'm super confident in my team, in myself, in my skills, in the way we will react to anything that might be unplanned in the schedule. And for that reason, I think that I can call that a risk under control situation. Before the show, after a day of preparation, morning of meditation, visualization of the whole performance and the whole day of work with my team, I go in my little world. I cannot be disturbed. And for the last 90 minutes, 1 hour and a half, I start the body preparation, the stretching, because we are not as flexible as we pretend we are on stage. We need a certain preparation to do that. And mental preparation. And I have to make sure my hands are ready, the grip, that I don't have creamy hands, or a lot of little details like that. Hair, costume. And the stretching is a very long process. First you warm up the muscles, then you have to do the, I call it active flexibility. So it's not that you just overstretch your whole body, but muscle by muscle, I activate the muscle, but in a full range of motion, which means completely stretched, I activate the muscle. So then the muscle will let itself be stretched, and then we reach a little bit more, and then we become contortionist in the air for the next 6 minutes. It sounds so simple. So when I go out in the cold before the show to get ready, and then I clip my aerial silks and I make sure that all the security, everything has been checked, double checked, triple checked, then we are ready 5 minutes, then we're ready 3 minutes, 2 minutes, 1 minute. Everyone gives their go, and I'm the very last to say, okay, I'm ready. We give the go, the music starts, and then I just start flying.